Hello children, welcome to biology class. This video is in continuity with the previous video of the chapter Human Health and Diseases. The various objectives we are going to cover in this video are communicable diseases caused by viruses such as influenza, swine flu, common cold, dengue, chikungunya, AIDS, that is acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. So first of all, talking about influenza, there are generally three types of flu viruses categorized as A, B and C. It is type A virus that causes serious flu epidemics in humans. So what is epidemic? The disease which spread at large scale. What is the cause of this disease? Influenza is caused by an RNA virus called myxovirus influenzae. And what is the mode of infection? It spreads through air by droplet infection. The droplets emitted into the air from sneeze, cough or spit of the infected person are laden with the virus. By inhaling the air containing these droplets, one can get the infection. So, what are the basic symptoms of influenza? Flu begins with body aches, a feeling of discomfort, followed by cough and cold. Within few hours, the body develops fever. The fever may range from 101 to 104 degree Fahrenheit, depending upon the type of infection. Along with high fever, the patient may suffer from running nose, cold and sneezing. So what is the prevention and control? The basic prevention is to stay away from the infected patient. There is no effective control for it. So next we will be discussing about swine flu. What is swine flu? Swine flu is also known as H1N1 flu. It is caused by the orthomyxovirus, which usually affects pigs, but due to mutations has started infecting humans as well. The swine influenza virus is an example of cross species viral infection, which was previously seen with other infections like from civet to humans. It is known as SARS, that is sudden acute respiratory syndrome, and from birds to humans as seen with avian flu. This type of effect is zoonotic effect, means which can pass from animals to humans. Now, how swine flu spreads? Swine flu is a highly contagious means infectious disease, and spreads through droplet infection and infected fluids. When an infected person sneezes or coughs, it releases tiny droplets containing virus in the air. Inhaling these droplets or touching the surface recently touched by an infected person can lead to swine flu. A person who has swine flu can be contagious from day 1 before they show symptoms to 7 days after they get sick. Children can be contagious for as long as 10 days. Now, what are the symptoms of swine flu? Fever with or without chills, means there is a condition when a person is feeling quite cold. Sore throat, cough and difficulty in breathing, fatigue, lethargy, headaches and general body ache, diarrhea and vomiting. Swine flu can lead to serious complications like pneumonia and respiratory failure, or serious symptoms such as shortness of breath, severe vomiting and dizziness can occur in a short span of time and can be fatal also. Fatal means it can cause death of a person. What is the treatment of swine flu? Oseltamivir, that is Tamiflu. The main drug is an antiviral drug that is useful both as a treatment and as a preventive measure against many influenza type viruses, including swine flu, SARS and bird flu. Zanamivir is another antiviral drug. What is the prevention of swine flu? How it can be prevented? First, avoiding close contact with a person suffering from flu. Always wash your hands after touching objects with a good antimicrobial soap. Practice good hygiene, and even the use of sanitizers should be accompanied. What is the diagnosis of swine flu? The symptoms of swine flu are non-specific, meaning that they can be seen as common cold or the common flu. A laboratory test of mucus is the confirmatory diagnosis. Next, we will be discussing about common cold. What is the cause of common cold? It is again one of most infectious human ailments. Common cold is caused by rhinovirus. Virus infects the nose and respiratory tract, but not the lungs. What is the mode of infection? Again, droplets, resulting from cough or sneeze of an infected person through contaminated objects like pens, book, doorknobs, mouse, etc., cause infection in a healthy person. What are the symptoms of common cold? Common cold is characterized by nasal congestion and discharge, sore throat and cough. Headache, tiredness and fever may follow. Usually lasts for a period of 3 to 7 days. Talking about prevention and control, the only prevention is to stay away from congested places and wash hands before eating or using the objects that may be contaminated. Again, there is no effective control for common cold. Next is dengue. Now, what is dengue? It is also known as Brakevann or dandy fever. The name Brakevann was given because of the contortions caused due to the intense joint and muscle pain. The name dandy fever was given because of the posture and gait of West Indian slaves who contracted dengue. Dengue hemorrhagic fever is more severe form and can be life-threatening or fatal. As earlier mentioned, fatal means it can cause death of a person. Now, what are the main causes? Dengue fever and dengue hemorrhagic fever are caused by dengue virus, which belongs to genus Flavivirus. This virus is transmitted by Aedes aegypti mosquito that has previously bitten an infected person. That is the reason when a person is suffering from dengue, is normally advised to cover their body so that again the mosquito may not bite them, and when that particular mosquito will bite the other individual, they will also get contaminated. What is the spread? How it spreads? Dengue virus is transmitted by the bite of an Aedes aegypti mosquito that has been infected with any one of the four dengue viruses. This species of mosquito flourishes during rainy season. However, they can breed all around the year in clean water, water-filled flower pots, plastic bags, and cans. Now, the symptoms of dengue. The incubation period. Incubation period means the time the infection enters the body and there is first appearance of a symptom in the body is called incubation period. The incubation period of dengue is usually 5 to 6 days. Dengue fever can affect all from infants to young children to adults, but is usually not fatal in nature. Abrupt onset of high fever, severe headache, muscle and joint pain, that is breakbone fever, rash and other hemorrhagic manifestations, fall in blood platelet count, vomiting and abdominal pain. Talking about dengue hemorrhagic fever, is a potentially deadly complication and its symptoms may include bleeding in gastrointestinal tract and sudden and severe fall in blood platelet count. Now talking about alarming signs, bleeding through nose and gums, refusal to food or drink, person doesn't feel like having anything, difficulty in breathing, reduced urination, minute spots on the skin signifying bleeding within the skin. Now, what is the treatment of dengue? There is no specific treatment or antibiotic for it. General medicine like Crocin is given to bring fever down and reduce body aches. The patient is advised to take complete rest and increase the intake of fluids. One should avoid aspirin and non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. What is prevention? First, currently there is no vaccine available. Best precaution of dengue is the prevention from mosquito bites. Use insect repellent containing lemon and eucalyptus on exposed skin. Wear full sleeve shirts and pants. Spray fumigant in open drains and do not allow standing water in flower pots, coolers, or any container at home. Now, talking about chikungunya. Chikungunya is a viral disease that is transmitted in humans by the bite of infected Aedes aegypti mosquitoes. It causes severe and persistent joint pain, body rash, headache, and fever. Initial symptoms are similar to that of dengue. It is usually not life-threatening, but the joint pains can last for a very long time and full recovery may take months. Usually, patient gets lifelong immunity from this infection, and so hence reinfections are very rare. Now, what is the cause? Chikungunya is caused by a virus, an alpha virus with a single-stranded RNA. It spreads. Chikungunya disease is a viral disease that spreads by a bite of infected Aedes aegypti mosquito. Aedes aegypti bites during the day. Hence, daytime mosquito bite is the main reason for the spread of this disease. Aedes mosquito thrives well in the clean, stale water present in vases, coolers, pots or pools, in and around the houses in hot and humid weather. Now, what are the symptoms of chikungunya? The incubation period, that is the period when the pathogen invades the body and the time is there between the appearance of the first disease. Symptoms, that is usually 2 to 12 days. The following are the symptoms: chills and high fever up to 40 degrees Celsius, vomiting and nausea, headache, persistent joint pain, painful joints, difficulty in walking, rash on the body after fever. Now, what is the treatment? So far, there is no antiviral drug or medicine available for the treatment of chikungunya. Paracetamol is given to relieve pain and reduce fever. Aspirin should be always avoided in case of dengue as well as chikungunya. Now, talking about prevention and control. As earlier mentioned, there is no vaccine so far available. Only way to prevent chikungunya is to avoid mosquito bites. Hence, mosquito breeding control is the best way to fight chikungunya. Last, we'll be discussing about AIDS, that is acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. Now, when we talk about AIDS, it is basically caused by HIV. Talking about the structure, this virus, it is a retrovirus. It contains a single-stranded RNA. Now, along with it is having one enzyme, that is reverse transcriptase. And the outer wall of this virus, it contains a glycoprotein called GP120, which is having non-antigenic layer. Now, how this virus spreads, means the mode of infection. Spreads through sexual contact with an infected person, from infected mother to child, even by sharing needles, razors, blades with someone who is infected, or by transfusion of infected blood. So what are the symptoms? It results in decreased blood platelet count, decreased immunity, loss of weight, cold, cough, typhoid, fever, and body's normal defense system against infection, it fails. Now, talking about the treatment. Incubation period, it may be from 3 to 12 years. Use of disposable blades and razors. Avoid sexual contact with unknown and infected person. So far, there is no effective cure against HIV, that is AIDS. So next, we'll be continuing in the next video. Thank you so much.